everybody. Today we are working with earthenware with Grog in it, and I'm going to construct a couple ollas for a local business. The olla is actually made from earthenware that is fired, just fired up to temperature. The piece remains unglazed, so the purpose of the olla is to filter water through for gardens. And for folks here in Texas where, you know, during the summertime, water gets pretty scarce, the olla is a really nice addition to your garden to help, you know, filter the impurities out of the water and slowly filter water into the garden. So with the olla construction, you basically use what's called a pookie, but they're also called bis forms in my world. So what you do is you start with a form like this. The olla basically is just really a round vessel with a long neck on the top, and the neck protrudes from the ground, so you bury the olla in your garden, and you just fill it with water on occasion. So what I'm going to try to do with the two pookies that I have here, one small and large, the little local nursery wants a couple pieces, so one will hold approximately a gallon of water, so you know it basically should hold enough water to fill this bucket. And then another one, it's going to be about 3 gallons, so it'll hold about the equivalent of this bucket. This bucket, so that second olla is going to be quite large. It'll be for probably people that are doing some very serious vegetable gardens. So what you do on a pookie basically is just stabilize it on one of the banding wheels. I'll just take a little bit of clay. And I'm going to just stretch it out by hand. I'm going to put it on the banding wheel top here so I can stabilize the pookie on the wheel. So I can use this to coil build. Now, I used a handheld extruder with a little die right here on the end to extrude out some coils so I can kind of speed up that process. Got a whole lot of coils right there. Bucket of water. Move this guy over so we can get some more water. A ruler so I can actually measure the diameter of the piece. I'm going to try to shoot for about an 8.5 inch diameter at the main section of the olla. Like I said, it's basically a round vessel with a top. It'll look basically like a old school light bulb when we're done here. So, okay, I'm gonna start with a coil. I'm gonna very tightly wrap the coil in the center. Press it down. Don't wanna see any seams. You want it really, really tight. These coils tend to pull apart, and when you use a pookie like this, it's a bisque form, it's going to wick the water away from this. I'm going to work a little fast, of course, to assemble it. I've got two banding wheels here, so basically I can feed the coil from one banding wheel to the larger banding wheel. Really want good attachment, so I'm pushing my thumb pretty hard across the seam on the coil here. Smooth the interior of this. I'm going to check the exterior, do the same thing. I'll pop it out of the pookie for a second, smooth the exterior of it. And then continue to build it until I get the height that I need so that I know that it can hold a gallon of water. So we're going to shoot for about a 10 inch height here, 8.5 inch diameter, and as you can see, once I've got the pookie, the first coil set started, you can see a got it in here, so now I'm going to smooth the bottom of it. I'll pop it out for a second. I'm going to smooth the exterior of it, get the seams to go away by smoothing the exterior, and then I'll start the build on the next part of it. I'm using a serrated rib to heal the seams on the interior. The clay is good and soft, so I can push a lot of clay around the interior of this vessel. Get those seams to heal up, basically. And a real crucial point is getting that base smoothed in and smoothed across. With the serrated rib, I've actually pushed it across the seams here. I'm putting quite a bit of pressure on that to get rid of the seams that you see in there. I'm going to go ahead and smooth the base of it and get that, the seams under the, you know, inside the Pookie itself healed up, and then I'll put it right back in the Pookie, and I'm going to go ahead and start the build. As you can see, I've flipped the base of the Oya out onto the Pookie. And you can see the seams of it relatively well here, so I'm going to use the same thing. I'm going to use the serrated rib to get rid of the seams. And the Pookie, you know, it's kind of, it's a bisque mold basically. Same as a slump and a hook mold. You have an interior and exterior that you can use for making items, so I basically can just pop it right out, flip it over the Oya on the Pookie flipped upside down. Finish off the bottom before I start the next parts of it. Compress into the Oya. Smooth the exterior, and then I'm going to flip it back inside the Pookie ring and work on the walls and build the height that I want. I want the Oya to be evenly pours. So I'm doing the same to the interior of this. Now that I got the walls built up, I'm starting to stiffen this guy up. I'm gonna get rid of the seams. I'm pressing really hard with the serrated edge around the vessel. I'm gonna get rid of the seams. I'm gonna compress the sides back in, and I'm gonna dry it a little bit more so I can continue to build and get the height on it that I want. Use enough water to get each successive coil to attach to the previous coil and to continue your build. And at a certain point too, this vessel will again, because of the wetness of the coils that I'm putting on and the wetness of the vessel itself, I'm going to need to stop, let it air dry for a little bit before I attach maybe the last few coils on the shoulder. But I also need to be able to get my hand inside it to integrate the coils into the wall of the vessels. I'm very gently sloping the coil in towards what's going to be the neck of the Oya to make the curve. I'm not pinching the coil into that position, I'm placing the coil into that position, which is very important. As you can see here, I'm very gently leaning the coil into the interior as I attach it. I've actually got enough clay on here that I could probably put maybe one more row coils on here and still get my hand inside the vessel so I can integrate this new row of coils to the base that I've already, you know, cleaned up the base on. I'll shoot for 6.5 inch size slab neck on this one. Of course, everything will shrink as it dries, so that looks like about the right size. Like I said, it'll look like a big, gigantic, upside down, bold light bulb when it's done. Little top on it. So let me get the slab prepared and you'll see what I'm doing. Okay, we're going to use this form to make the neck for the Oya, and I'm measuring the diameter that I'm, you know, the basic diameter that I'm going to need to get around this tube here. Okay, so we've got the neck of the Oya all set up. It's starting to get a little bit harder. I'm going to go ahead and wrap it around this form to drape it over and make the connection and let it start to set up and stiffen up. So again, I'm using my serrated rib to score and make slip with a little bit of water on the rib on the beveled edge that I've cut. I'm going to press it around this form to get it into the round shape that I need it for. So I'm going to wrap it around very gently, and do it on the bottom so I can stand this guy up. slab itself should be just slightly bigger than the form you're pressing it onto. Take the serrated rib, and I'm just going to remove a little bit of the extra clay here. Smooth it down to the surface. A little more even, so you don't absolutely see that join there. Kind of an invisible join. This one. You don't want to let these things dry up on forms like that, especially if you don't have plastic or something underneath here, because it'll stick to the form. So it's going to sit there and it's going to dry up, air dry on its own for a little while. And while that one is air drying, I'm going to roll out one more slab. The slab's going to be the top, and I'm going to coil a small interior there, so the lid for the Oya has an inset galley right there on it. Hi, Mud Wranglers. Here we go. We're on day 2 of build of the Oya. I've made all my parts, they've all set up. The Oya itself has gotten a little bit stiffer, as you can see, still a little soft, so I'm gonna leave it supported on the bottom here. But I have the chimney, the top part of it, built right now, just made out of a slab that I wrapped, as I showed earlier, wrapped around the cylinders to help support the shape of it. So now I'm just gonna trim this cylinder up. While that cylinder was also starting to set up, I actually cut just a little round slab again from the same slab that I did for the cylinder, the same width of that slab, and I'm going to use that for the top of the Oya. We'll put a little coil inside the lid so that it actually fits tight to the chimney of the Oya. So in order to put the chimney on the top, it's going to look like a really funny upside down light bulb once this is done. I'm going to rasp off the top of this so I get a nice flat edge to put the chimney on the top of this with. So just work that down a little bit. I'm going to pull it towards myself. As you can see, the Oya is still pretty soft. So it's giving a little bit there. Get a nice smooth top so the chimney section will fit right on top. It'll lay flat, not have to worry about cutting an angle. I'm going to also flatten the bottom and the top of the chimney to the Oya. Actually, the bottom I think looks pretty flat. Yep, maybe just the top needs a little touch up here. Side of it, but I am going to score pretty much everything that I attach here. So, use a little bit of water, a serrated rib. Still got coils left over that I kept in plastic all wrapped up just for this purpose. Like this side's probably the flattest side, so I'm going to score this too, also with a serrated rib. And I want the inside and the outside to be connected, so I'm going to take a coil here, and I'm going to attach a coil to the interior of the piece. Just a little bit, it's a little thick. Okay, I'm going to attach this coil to the interior of the chimney. Put a little water here. Roll this piece of coil that I extruded down just a little bit so it's a little bit thinner. Cut it to the right size. The chimney so I can roll this down into the join on the interior. Attach this here. And then I'll put a join a coil to join the exterior of it too. Weight, which is good. So work that coil into the piece. Use this handy dandy little dowel on the end of a stick. Make these with parts from your hobby store locally, and I'm gonna smooth down the interior seam with this guy. The coil will expand as I try to work it into the seam, so. Okay, so now I'm just gonna work this into my seam, and I'm literally just gonna use my finger. I'm gonna compress it down, get rid of any air in that gap. I'm gonna smooth it into the gap so that you can't see any seams. Okay, it's pretty much done. Just gotta finish the edges here. Like I said, I'm gonna make a top. I'll put a little coil on the interior of the top. I'll cut the lid down to it so that the top lifts right up. You'll be able to bury this, water your garden, you know, really handy here in the Texas heat. So, there you go. First lesson. Thanks. Bye.